My name's Rocco, Rocco Zito. I'm from the Barbara Hardy Institute, which is UniSA's sustainability institute that they've set up. In that institute, I head up transport systems. So within transport systems, we run a number of research projects, as well as do a whole bunch of teaching. We run coursework masters program, as well as a number of HDR programs, both PhD and masters as well. The way I started, I was an undergraduate civil engineer at UniSA. When I graduated right in the middle of the recession we had to have. So there weren't too many jobs around, but one that was going was actually within the university. Professor Taylor had recently joined the university and just won a large ARC grant and was looking for a research assistant to work on it. So I applied for that job and was successful and have been here at UniSA researching transport systems ever since. A good pathway into a research career, straight from the undergraduate. If they seem to enjoy the research, they can always move into some sort of postgraduate qualification, whether it be coursework masters like the one we run. There are several others at UniSA as well, PhD programs possibly as well, or just starting out as a research assistant and building up and developing your research career as you go along, which is essentially what I did. I think the support that UniSA gives, not only the library, but the support of the infrastructure within all the research concentrations, like the Barbara Hardy Institute and the various other institutes at UniSA, they have a lot of embedded infrastructure and knowledge within those research institutes where some real key research outcomes happen. My research background, what I'm specialising now, is twofold really. It's in intelligent transport systems, and their main aim is to get the most effective and efficient use of the existing transport network. So not only making it efficient, but also making it safe, and using new technologies to do that. So ITS, as it's commonly known as in the industry, is really a forging in industry internationally, and there's a lot of development in using technologies like variable speed signs. We've got some examples of them up at the Hyson Tunnels. Our two freeways use CCTV to monitor the traffic and look for any types of incidents. So using all these new technologies, especially communications technologies, to make more efficient use of the transport system. So that's one area of research that I'm heavily involved with. Another area is the environmental impacts of transport. So I do a lot of work in evaluating emissions from vehicles and developing emissions models so that when we try and implement some sort of transport policy, we can not only have a look at what impacts it has on transport efficiency, but what impacts it has on the environment as well. We were really fortunate with myself and two other key researchers in transport systems being nominated for the National Museum's Eureka Prize. That project was that nomination was all about our Nexus database system. Basically, that system is a very large database that stores all the traffic signal information throughout Adelaide. In Adelaide, we have about 750 traffic signals. Each set of traffic signals has about a maximum of about 24 detectors. Each one of those detectors, every 5 minutes, actually counts the number of vehicles that go across that detector. So all that information gets stored, as well as all the traffic light information. How long was the green time for? How long was it amber? How long was it red? When did the pedestrian press the buttons and activate the signals? All that information actually gets stored, but what we found in our research, it was actually never getting used. So it wasn't until we developed our Nexus database that we're actually starting to use that data to not only effectively try and manage and quantify how well we were using the transport system, but to try and predict what enhancements we could do to the transport system to make it even more efficient. So it's really another ITS type technology or research area that we're trying to develop to improve traffic efficiency and, of course, environmental outcomes as well. The resource of the library for researchers is absolutely essential. One of the key research questions that continually gets asked in all research areas is, what's the gap in knowledge? The only way you can find out what the gap in knowledge is with extensive lit reviews, access to journals, publications. They are absolutely essential for any type of research project to start to look for those research gaps and where they are. What is the current world's best practice in that particular research area, and where are those gaps? And it's the literature that the library holds or subscribes to that's absolutely essential to find out what those gaps and those research questions really are. Oh, it's a great environment to do research in at UniSA. The infrastructure, the facilities, both the physical hardware that's available to enable you to do your research, whether it's advanced computers, access to large data sets, but it's even the resources in the people as well. There are a lot of experts at UniSA, and no matter what your problem is, there will always be someone that you can tap on the shoulder and ask them for a bit of advice, and they can send you in the right area.